Sypniewski.
And if not, I got a 50-foot fucking mic cable, so I'ma just come over there my goddamn self. Or a band called Sharptooth from Baltimore.
I'm not sure.
need to survive. This is where I come alive. This is what I need to survive. Thank you. Fuck yeah. How we doing tonight? We doing okay? Hanging in there? Thank you so much for coming and hanging out with us. Thank you so much for popping off and moshing and having a good time. That really fucking means a lot. So yesterday was Mental Health Awareness Day. And I just want to make you all aware that my mental health is fucking terrible. So it's funny because it's not fucking funny. Because I'm sure the same goes for a lot of people in this room. I'm sure that a lot of us, maybe not right now, maybe not this month or this week or this year, but I'm sure that a lot of us at some point or another have struggled with mental illness. I think that's a reality for most people who get involved in this kind of music, because I don't think that you get involved with this kind of music by being extremely happy and well-adjusted. At least I don't. For a lot of us, this is one of the only places that we can go where we feel like we can express ourselves. But for some fucking reason, we still live in a world where people want to stigmatize and shit talk people with lesser known mental illnesses. Things like autism or Tourette's, borderline personality disorder, bipolar disorder, PTSD, and addiction. There are a lot of fucking people out there who want to run their goddamn mouths about some shit they have not fucking lived. So I'll tell you what, Cleveland, you may not be that person, but you might know that person. And if you are that person, I hope you fucking know that when we die, our blood is on your hands. Upon my grave and tell me that I deserved it. Would you spit upon my grave and tell me my life was worthless?
You fought that trouble on the cross.
You say that I am deserveless.
You fought this up on the cross.
They said that our lives were worthless. You guys are great. I really appreciate each and every one of you here tonight. So how many of y'all have seen Sharptooth before? Hey, welcome back. Thank you so much for coming and hanging out with us again. How many of y'all, this is your first time ever seeing Sharptooth? Thank you so much for choosing to spend part of your night with us. So if you don't know us, there are certain things that I think it's important for us to talk about at our shows. And some of these things really fucking suck. So let's just get right to it. For those of you who don't know me or this band, I've been raped multiple times, and I guarantee you I'm not the only fucking person in this room who has had that experience. I do not bring this up because I like fucking talking about it, because frankly, having to get on stage and talk about my trauma every fucking day is really draining and exhausting. Sexual violence, I see it as this band's responsibility for us to find each other and to unite with each other, and so that you know, and you know, and you know that you are not alone. We believe you. We fucking listen to survivors. So if you or someone you know is a victim of sexual violence, come and talk to us. You are not alone. I see you. You, because I am you. This song is for you, and it is called Left for Dead.
Ah!
again all for being here. Yo, it's National Coming Out Day. That's a fucking thing. That's pretty sick. I'm queer as fuck. I'm sure a bunch of us here are too. That's really cool. So whether you are or are not out, I hope you know that every single Sharptooth show is a place for you. It's a place for everyone, regardless of your age or ability or your gender identity or your sexuality or your race or your religion or your country of origin. This is a place where we take care of each other, mind, body, and spirit. When someone's down, you pick them up physically and emotionally. We create these spaces so that we can help to elevate one another. And if raising people up does not resonate with you, then you don't gotta be here. But if it does, this is your fucking place. Right here, right now. Cause I'll tell you what, Cleveland, out there, there is no fucking sanctuary! Go! The word you say, and here you go! The life is full. A bigger time. Think of the dog. There's one in tall. There's one control. You hold the vibe. There's one more ball by your triglycs. An atmosphere feeds a tube. Another person's on a night. There's every part of the bullshit. Is on the run. You are complicit. Every time the shooting you who want the world a blameless man doesn't matter if the gun was in your hand. So when you speak, crack your back, and you remove a little sun, and all you've done justify suicide's the head. So when you see all of our bodies on the floor, you can give thanks unto your motherfucking Lord.
Come on!
were by their seats. After someone fucking lived, to take another chance to die. If I'm not I, climb on to fight for freedom. All day, fight for his greed. Till I fall to cross the line. Talk a lot. But frankly, until there is more representation for women and for marginalized voices in heavy music, until I'm not the only goddamn girl you see on this motherfucking stage all night, then I'm just gonna have to keep running my fucking mouth. And frankly, they can just try to shut us up. So this last one is for all my fucking ladies. Overreacting, or maybe you shouldn't be so fucking dramatic. Us nasty, nasty women, us mad as fuck bitches who get shit anytime we open our fucking mouths and got a motherfucking opinion about something. So this shit! Dead men tell no tales! Dead men!
Dead men!
Yeet!